Yo, yo, it's the Ask Jason Question series. Every Monday at 2, we answer questions. People send questions here, but you don't have to send questions. For the past couple months, we've been talking about how we can encourage you and help you and answer more general questions as we're dealing with this pandemic and trying to come out of this downturn. That's kind of what we've been focused on the past couple months, and we're doing that through May too. So we've taken a little time out to answer people's questions so we can talk directly to the things we believe you should be doing to come out of this pandemic. So thanks for joining us on the Ask Jason Question series. We want to say thank you to Bill.com. They're our sponsor, and our firm has been using Bill.com for 8 or 9 years, something like that. And they have an AI-enabled platform that learns your businesses. Learns your clients' businesses. So any kind of controllership as a virtual firm, any controllership work we do for clients automatically runs through the Bill.com platform because of its ability to be robust with international payments, integrated document management system, full APAR. It's actually, you know, probably for 8 or 9 years how we have drafted our clients every month. So that's just part of how we do things. So thank you, Bill.com. They've redesigned the program, so check it out. So what we want to talk about this time is really investments about the future. This is a common question we hear, especially in some of the groups that we teach, and we're going to be teaching. We are turning our incubator, our very famous, well-known incubator program, the Thriveal Incubator. We're turning that virtual, so you can actually go to thriveal.com/incubator and start to see some of the things we're doing with that program. So in those kind of programs, we teach things called investments. And so we talk about what is an investment. Well, you kind of know what an investment is, right? If you have money invested in the stock market, you did it with your current resources, right? So you set aside some current resources and you're hoping there's some payoff in the future. That's an investment. And as entrepreneurs, you have to run your business that way. So an investment is any kind of current expenditure of resource, cash, anything that you give up now for some future change in your business. And so as entrepreneurs, we're always assessing the risk of investments. And right now, we just want to encourage people that now's not the time to make heavy investments in changing your firm, changing your model. Now, you are going to broaden your services to come out of this downturn and to stay safe, to keep cash flowing, which is a key. But investments are things where you're betting on the market. You're seeing something new come down the pipe for 12 months out. That's what you're hoping for. So you're going to expend some kind of cash. You might invest in a whole brand new team member, some different kind of role you've never had in your firm before. And that's because you hope it might pay off and be something in the future that's going to set you apart. Well, those kind of investments are right now a little too risky. So we're talking to people about not really making those current investments right now. Though there are things you have to spend money on and you have to plan maybe 8 to 12 months from now to come out of this pandemic leading the way and coming out of this economic downturn. That's what you're going to have to do. But what you're doing in the short term is trying to just keep the cash flow going so that when you come out of this, you can be stronger than you were going into it. Why would you be stronger than you were going into it? It's because coming into this pandemic, you're going to learn a lot of things you didn't know. So you will have not known some things that you were operating under before. This pandemic is going to teach you some things. You're going to be smarter, so when you come out of it, you can be stronger than you were before, because you're going to have a lot more wisdom than you have before. So we're just saying, hold off on investments. Be careful about investments because it's really hard to bet on the future of a market right now that is really confused, fearful, has a layer of distrust, skepticism. All of that's embedded in our market right now. So what you're trying to do is get that recurring revenue, get even shorter projects right now, create cash flow, let your team know they may be doing other things to produce and service that kind of cash flow, because you want to stay in business probably for the next 8 to 12 months. So investments can derail you. Typically, when you make investments, you do it with cash you already have set aside that you don't need. And you don't need to make investments with your PPP money, right? That's not what it's for. So there's some thoughts on investments. I hope that's encouraging. And guys, we are going to make it out of this as a profession, and we are going to come out of this stronger than before because of all that we're learning. I know we're learning so much. It's even hard to swallow all of the learning we're taking in on a daily basis. It's huge. But we're going to be stronger as a profession, a service-based profession, when we come out of this. So just watch those investments. excuse me. So that's it. Thank you for joining us on the Ask Jason Question Series. We'll see you next Monday. Take care.